I'm going to write third row expansion. Everyone see what is the third row is. So third row expansion is, that is the first to third column expansion. This zero, only this one is the remaining, this one is the zero. So this is the minus. So second, no means first row, we can apply first row only cos x. First row only can apply cos x. So this is the zero minus 2x, zero minus 2x minus x is cofactor in zero minus 2 tan x, zero minus 2 tan x. Right, next one is third element is the zero, right? Simplify, write down the equation f dash x. Everyone simplify and write down f dash x. Everyone simplify and write down f dash x. F dash of x is equal to, so minus x square sine x, minus x square sine x, minus x square minus minus is the plus x square sine x. Here is minus 2x cos x, minus minus is the plus 2x square secant square x, 2x square secant square x plus 2 cos x plus 2 cos x minus x square secant square x minus x square secant square x. Look at that. Minus x square secant square x. Next one here, we are go through the minus 2x cos x, minus 2x cos x, minus 2x cos x. Here is second one, see one time. This is the minus 2x cos x, okay? Minus 2x cos x. That is the one we have to see. One is the 2x cos x. 2x cos x. That is the 2x cos x. Here is the 2x cos x. 2x cos x. Minus minus is the plus 2x tan x. 2x tan x. Right, simplify everyone. 2x cos x, 2x cos x is cancelled in this one. 1 x square is the less. So now I will write f dash of x is equal to x square sine x. So minus 2x cos x plus x square secant square x plus 2x tan x plus 2x tan x. Now apply the limit. Everyone now apply the limit. Now apply the limit, everyone. Limit x tends to 0, na? Limit x tends to 0, is it correct? Limit x tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0. F dash of x by x. F dash of x by x. Right, so write down the simplification. Limit x tends to 0. F dash value is the x square sine x minus 2x cos x. So plus x square secant square x plus 2x tan x upon x. In numerator, all terms x is common and cancelled with the denominator x. Limit x tends to 0. X is common. X sine x minus 2 cos x, x secant square x plus 2 tan x upon x. X term should be cancelled. Now substitute x place is the 0. Now substitute x place is the 0. So that is equal to x is 0 means first one is 0. Minus 2 cos of 0 degrees. Second one 0. Third one is the 2 tan of 0 degrees. So tan cos 0 degree value is the 1. Minus 2. And this value is the 0. Answer is the minus 2. Right, I go through the fifth problem. I go through the fifth problem, everyone see? Right, everyone go through the fifth problem. Fifth problem is, everyone see the fifth problem. If y is equal to sine of px, px is the angle of sine, and yn is the nth derivative, yn is the nth derivative, nth derivative, n times derivative, yn is the nth derivative of y, then determinant of y, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, y8 value is required, its net value is required. Options also given. First option is a minus one. Second option is a zero. Third option is a one. Fourth option is a two. Right. Note down the options also. Now start everyone. Yn is the nth derivative. N times derivative. So already y is given. First time derivative right now. Y1 is equal to sine derivative the cos of px by the chain rule. P derivative, px derivative is the p coefficient. X is therefore p is the term. Y2 derivative right now. So cos derivative is minus sine so of px by the chain rule. Px derivative is the p. P into p will become as a p square. Next, write on the y3 derivative. Derivative of y3 minus p square. Sine derivative is the cos of px. Px derivative is the p. It will become as a p cube. Now, write on y4. So, minus sine is the plus. P power of 4 sine of px. Y5 right out. So px one more is came p power of 5 cos of px. Now write down the y6. Y6 is equal to minus p power of 6 sine of px. Y7 write out minus p power of 7 cos of px. Right, y8 write down, minus is the plus, p power of 8 into sine of px, right, everyone. Now substitute in the determinant, everyone write down in the determinant. Now substitute in the determinant, everyone, what is the determinant value we can be observed? Substitute in the determinant y, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, y8, y1. Y1 value is the p cos of px. Y2 value is the minus p square of sine of px, right? Y3 value is minus p cube of sine of cos of px. Y4 value is, sine of px, y1 value is my P cos of PX, Y2 value is minus P square of sine of PX, Y3 value is minus P cube cos of PX, Y4 value is P power of 4 sine of PX, P power of 5 cos of PX, Y6 value is minus P power of 6 sine of PX, Y7 value is minus P power of 7 cos of PX, Y8 value is P power of 8 sine of PX. Right, everyone observe. In this one, I am going to take the common of, so P term I am going to take the common, that is the same will be formed by the observe. Everyone will get the same. So in the third column, minus P square take common. Third column, minus P square take common. So from the third column, minus P square take common. So first one is the same, sine of PX, and minus P cube cos of PX. First column, minus P power of C, sine of PX. Second column is the same, right down, P cos of PX, P power of 4 sine of PX, minus P power of 7 cos of PX. Third column, minus P square take common, minus P square means plus sine of PX. Here is minus P cube cos of PX. Here is minus P power of 6 sine of PX. So now first two column, third column, both are same. First column and third column both are same. First column and third column both are same. So therefore debt value is 0. Debt value is 0. Where we have the answer is the second option ticket. First column and third column both are same. Right. I go through the higher order derivatives and successive differentiation. So this model C is completed. Next, I go through the model of higher order derivative. It is also in our test book, last exercise. Higher order derivative, second derivative, third derivative. Everyone, put the heading is higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives or another name is successive differentiation. Successive means one by one. Successive differentiation. First one, next, second one. Continuous differentiation. Successive differentiation. So, derivative topic is in continuity and differentiability. We have in that one, continuity, differentiability topics we can eliminate. Then we get the, so derivative topics is there, fifth topic. In that one, derivative part only you can prepare for subject to examination. Okay, now continuity, differentiability, we have two exercises. First two exercises only. So two is not necessary. Next, we have to prepare for derivative part only. Okay. Right. Successive higher order derivative. So higher order derivative is What is the first one derivative? What is the representation of the higher order derivatives? Everyone see? Higher order derivatives. Everyone observe higher order derivatives. So what is the higher order derivatives is, everyone see, first derivative is, so if y is equal to f of x be the function, f of x be continuous, it is continuous, so otherwise no break, continuous and differentiable, it will be continuous and differentiable, and differentiable function, no break, only continuously differentiable is possible. Differentiable, then first derivative we can write it as a first derivative is represented by dy by dx. This is the one symbol. R, so f dash of x we can represent, R y1 we can represent, R y dash we can represent, R capital D dash y also we can represent. These also first derivative representation. Second derivative representation is d by dx of again derivative of first one again derivative, it is represented by d square y by dx square, or f double dash of x, or y2, or y double dash, or capital D square y is also representation. Third derivative is again derivative of second time derivative with respect to x. This is represented by d cube y by dx cube. This is represented by f triple dash of x. This is represented by y3. This is y triple dash d cube y. Okay, now fourth, so we can continuously we can write nth derivative is, so this is again derivative of, so n minus 1 derivative, again derivative of n minus 1 derivative, it is represented by d power of n y by dx power of n, so f power of n x or y n or y power of n or d power of n y, these are the representation of nth derivatives. Okay, now these are the representation of the nth derivatives. Right, basing these point, now we are going to work out the problems. Already we work out in the exercise problems only, here is repeating. So already exercise problems only we are going to repeat here. Right, see everyone. Right, everyone see. If first problem, if y is equal to a cos of log x plus b sine of log x, then the value of x square y2, two times derivative, x y1 plus y is equal to, what is the answer for it? What is the answer for it? Options also I will write here. First option is the 0, second option is the minus 2y, third option is the 1, fourth option is the minus 5y. These are the options is given. So I will do the problem. Everyone observe. So with fast reading, fast we can be do in the examination, it will become as a 3 steps. So otherwise we can do the each and every step on the paper means it will take nearly half an hour. So don't take more time. You should be work out by the mind calculation. That is the most important. I will write, see how to write mind calculation is first derivative, 2 times derivative is required. 2 times derivative, highest derivative is the 2 times. 2 times derivative, first time derivative. Cos a coefficient, cos derivative is the minus sign. So minus sign of log x. Log x derivative is the denominator 1 by x. Write down this one, finish. By the chain rule. B coefficient, cos derivative, sin derivative is the cos of log x. By the chain rule, cos x derivative is the 1 by x. That is a by x. Next step is direct x cross multiply. LCM is the same. Though in this problem, denominator always cross multiplication. Denominator, you should be remember, x is cross multiplication, x cross multiplication, it will become as a x, y, 1. Finish. One step is mind calculation is over. Okay, man? Right. Now apply the derivative, second time derivative. Again differentiation with respect to x. This is the u into v derivative, u into v derivative x. Y1 derivative will become as a y2. Y1 is the keep silent, x derivative is 1. Minus sine derivative is the cos of log x. By the chain rule, here is a. By the chain rule, cos log x derivative is 1 by x. Minus b, the sine of log x. Log x derivative is 1 by x. Okay, x cross multiplication. X square y2 plus x y1. Minus is common. A cos of log x. Less b sine of log x. Same problem. See, this is the y, x square y2. 2 times derivative is over. Stop the derivative. X y1. This value is the y. Given problem is the same. Minus y comes on this side. Plus y is equal to 0. Pick the first option is correct one. Only 3 steps. 3 steps also not necessary. If you are doing the mind calculation, only 2 steps it will be completed. Right. Second problem. I will write second problem. Everyone see. Every 2-3 steps only. This is not necessary. Again, differentiation already know that 1 by x is came, cos multiplication. One step we can write this step, and direct we can write down. This is also not necessary. Already know that this is the y. No, only this step, and we get this answer. Right, write down the second problem, everyone. Second problem, if y is equal to x plus root over x square plus 1 whole power of m, then the value of x square plus 1 into y2 plus xy1 plus xy1 minus m square y is equal to. One time we can do the first. Everyone, you can do the first. Only I will do the step by step. I will do the first one derivative is the y1. First power derivative by the chain rule m into x plus root over x square plus 1 whole power of m minus 1. First power derivative completed. Inner function derivative by the chain rule x derivative 1 root derivative is a 1 by 2 root over x square plus 1. Under root function derivative by the chain rule is the x square derivative is the 2x. 2 is cancelled. So here y1 is equal to m into x plus root over x square plus 1 whole power of m minus 1 by the LCM root over x square plus 1 plus x by denominator is the root over x square plus 1. So in successive derivative or higher order derivative, denominator always cross multiplication. And this term, both are same. Both are same. Bases are equal, power should be cut. So root over x square plus 1 into y1 is equal to m into power should be adding. It will become as a x plus root over x square plus 1 whole power of m. This is the same y value. Write down the y value. So now root over x square plus 1 into y1 is equal to m into y. But answer is telling that 2 times derivative, only 1 time derivative is completed. Second, for the second time derivative, first this is squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So x square plus 1 into y1 square is equal to m square into y square. Okay, now apply the differentiation. Now apply the differentiation. U into v formula. U into v formula. X square plus 1. Y1 first power derivative. 2 into y1 to the power of 2 minus 1. Y1 will derivative is y2 plus y1 square x square plus 1 derivative is 2x is equal to right side in is equal to m square coefficient y square derivative is 2 into y to the power of 2 minus 1 y by the chain rule y derivative is the y1 now take. So x square plus 1 into 2y1 into y2 plus 2yx, 2y1 square x is equal to 2 m square y1. 2y1 is common and cancel. 2y1, 2 1y1, 2 1y1 is cancelled on both sides. What is the remaining answer is x square plus 1 into y2 plus xy1 is in minus m square y is equal to 0. That's enough. You should practice this problem. Firstly, we can do. They cannot change the number also. Each and every one same they will give for subject to, for object to also. Never be changed. At least one term also they cannot change. Right, go through the third problem. Everyone go through the third problem. First, write down the third problem, everyone. Write down the third problem. The third problem is, if x is equal to a into 1 minus cos cube theta parametric form, y is equal to a into sine cube theta, then d square y by dx square, then d square y by d square y by dx square at theta is equal to pi by 6, right? Find out problem first. We can do parametric form. First parametric form, write down everyone. Dy by dx is equal to dy by dx is equal to dy by d theta by dx by d theta. Dy by d theta, write down. So a sine cube theta is the 3 sine square theta by the chain rule. Sine theta derivative is cos theta. A coefficient 1 derivative 0 minus power derivative 3 into cos square theta by the chain rule. Cos theta derivative is the minus sine theta. Right, simplify. So a is cancelled. So dy by dx, we get it as a 3 cancel, 1 sine, 1 cos cancel, total is the tan theta, right? So second time derivative, write down d square y by dx square mean. First time derivative, again derivative with respect to x, dy by dx, again derivative. So d by dx of dy by dx value is the tan theta. Here two functions are different. Different functions is given means by the chain rule again represent tan theta derivative is the secant square theta. Theta x different, that's why d theta by dx. D theta by dx. So now write down d square y by dx square is equal to secant square theta. Dx by dt reverse order, write down. Dx by dt reverse order, that is 1 by 3 cos square theta sin theta. D minus minus plus 3 cos square theta sin theta. So dx by dt, but it is the dt by dx means reverse. And now d square y by dx square. D square y by dx square at theta is equal to 30 degree substitute. Secant 30 value is, secant 30 value is the 2 by root 3, 4 by 3, 1 by 3 into cos 30 degrees value is the root 3 by 2 means 3 by 4. Sin 30 degrees value is the 1 by 2. Reverse write down. 4 by 3, 1 by 3, 4 by 3, and 2 by 1. Now simplification, 32 by 27 is the required answer. 32 by 27 is the required answer. 32 by 27 is the required answer. Okay, clear everyone? Right, now I am going to stop today.